हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू टैलेंट हब ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट फिनसोल सेगमेंट। हाउ आर यू? होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर सेफ एंड एट योर होम। वी नो दैट इन दिस प्रेजेंट सिनेरियो मेनी ऑफ यू वांट टू स्टार्ट योर ओन बिजनेस, बट देन यू फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ लीगल चैलेंजेस एंड लॉट्स ऑफ ऑप्शन इज ऑल्सो देयर, सो टेकिंग डिसीजन इज बिट टफ। आई नो आई नो। हियर वी आर ट्राइंग टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम बाय सिंपल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ बिजनेस ओरिएंटेड लीगल कंप्लायंस। For this, we introduce a video session with different videos. And overall above, from here you can take a certification by completing this session, just via online exam. Every video description will provide the link. But we request to all of our viewers, first go through all the 8 video sessions, then avail the test for better result. Because we will only provide the certification for those will secure the 60% of marks. So let's start our session.
Today, let's look at some basic registrations and licenses for SMEs to run a business smoothly and legally. Basically, the registrations are based on the structure of business and its activity. Here, the business registrations are categorized into 3 types: mandatory registration, industry-based registration, and credibility and other registrations. Let's understand each one in brief. Mandatory registration. After registering the business as a firm or company, one needs to take some other business registrations. This type of registrations are mandated by government under different acts. Following registrations or licenses are included in mandatory registrations: PAN and TAN. PAN is required for all persons to pay income tax and file income tax returns. It is mandatory for all types of business structure except proprietorship firm. Because in a proprietorship firm, a PAN of a proprietor is considered as a PAN of the firm. TAN is mandatory for all the persons who deduct tax at source. It is mandatory to pay tax to the government, which is deducted as TDS from its suppliers, service providers, employees, etc. Shop and establishment. It is mandatory to register a business with the local municipality of the city. The registration must be taken within 30 days of incorporation of a business. Professional tax. It is required for every type of business carrying on trade, service or profession, subject to the threshold limit. It is a registration with the state government. There are 2 parts in professional tax, which are PTRC, Professional Tax Registration Certificate, which is for the company or firm to pay tax on its trade, service or profession, and PTEC, Professional Tax Enrollment Certificate, for deducting tax of its employees. GST, Goods and Service Tax. It is a tax on the supply of goods or services. It is mandatory if the turnover exceeds rupees 20 lakh. Further, it is also mandatory in following cases: even the turnover does not exceed the limit, for an e-commerce operator or input service distributor, if the person is a non-resident taxable person, is a casual taxable person, person deducting TDS or TCS in GST, a person who is required to pay tax under the reverse charge mechanism, agents of supplier or franchisee, a person providing online information or database service from outside India into India, such other person as notified by the government. Provident Fund. Any entity having 20 or more employees has to take registration for a Provident Fund. Such an entity has to contribute to the Provident Fund account of its employees. Industry-based registrations. This type of registrations are based on the business activity of the entity. If you are carrying any activity related to any special industry, then it is necessary for your organization. FSSAI, Food Safety and Standards Authority license. It is mandatory to open a business related to food, such as manufacturers and traders of food products and for restaurants and cafes. Factory license. It is mandatory for every factory having 10 or more workers. If the manufacturing processes include machines operated by electric power or 20 or more in any other case. NOC for pollution under control. Every manufacturing industry must take NOC from the State Pollution Control Board to declare its unit is free from air and water pollution. IEC, Import-Export Code. It is required to carry on business internationally. It is an online one-time registration with lifetime validity. Further, it does not have any post-compliance requirements. RERA, Registration of Real Estate Projects. It is mandatory for every builder, developer, development authority to carry on real estate projects. Real estate projects include construction or development of a building or converting whole or a part of the existing building into apartments, development of land and as specified in the Act. IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. A license from IRDAI is mandatory to carry on services related to insurance. One can avail license from different types of insurance such as life insurance or general insurance. RBI, Reserve Bank of India. A license from RBI is required to carry on business of banking activity, providing loans and advances or financial assistance such as NBFCs. It is also required for providing services related to e-wallets. SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India. A license from SEBI is required for every person providing services of stock broking or sub-broking. Credibility registrations. The Government of India has mandated this type of registration for manufacturing certain products which must be qualified according to the standards provided. It increases the credibility of the entity. ISO and ISI mark. ISO is an international certification and it is to certify that the products or services are of significant quality. ISI is a certification based on Indian standards for industrial products. Many companies enter into contract only with the entities having ISO or ISI mark. AgMark. It is a certification mark for the agricultural products provided by the Government of India. It shows the quality of the product according to set standards. It is mandatory for certain specified agro products. BIS hallmark. It is for jewelries made up of gold and silver. It shows the purity of gold or silver used in the jewelry. Using such mark increases the trust of the customers. Other registrations. These are some voluntary registrations which are not mandatory but beneficial for startups. MSME, Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. It is for the promotion and growth of the businesses operating at small or medium scale. Only a manufacturer and service provider can register and trade. Hence, an entity carrying only a trading activity is not eligible for MSME registration. Further, government has categorized the entities on the basis of their investments such as micro, small and medium enterprises. Only such entities can be registered under this scheme. Entities registered under it can avail benefits such as loan at a subsidized rate, specified percentage of rebate on fees of intellectual property registration, protection against delayed payment from its customers, etc. Startup India, a private limited company or an LLP or registered partnership firm can get the recognition under Startup India scheme. Further, an entity must also fulfill the criteria specified under the scheme. An entity can avail the following benefits by registering under it. Income tax exemption for 3 years on capital gains investments received, fast track process and 80% rebate in an application for patent. It can avail alternate investment funds. Stand Up India. It is to facilitate the scheduled caste or scheduled tribe or women entrepreneurs by providing low interest loans from bank. In case of other than individuals, such benefits can be gained only if at least 50% of the shares are held by scheduled caste or scheduled tribe or a women entrepreneur. Conclusion. Once the business is incorporated, one must get all other applicable registrations done and or licenses to carry out the business legally. Otherwise, the government may charge a penalty for non-compliance with the rules and regulations. It is important to check regularly whether the business entity starts falling under any of the specified criteria by the government due to which a need arises for taking licenses which were not applicable earlier to avoid consequences. Thank you. That is it for Chapter 3.